See, so we are going to discuss today. Today we are going to discuss the most of the important tuning method in the industrial controller. This is the most conventional method, you can say, the Jigler-Nicholas tuning method. Okay. So, in order to understand the tuning, we have discussed the what is the tuning in the previous class, and also we have discussed the error and trial method, how the error and trial method is used in order to tune the PID controller. I have also shown one video on that empirical gain modeling or empirical gain tuning, or you can say simply the heat and trial tuning. Okay, today our point of discussion is the Jigler-Nicholas method. So, very interesting, Jigler-Nicholas are two engineers. Okay, they are not the researcher or not the academician. They are the, engineer. Okay, so in 1930, Nathaniel-Nicholas worked at Taylor Instruments, right? Taylor Instruments company in Rochester as a process control engineer. There, he met chemical engineer John Jigler. John Jigler se wahan pe unki mulaqat hui, and together they developed and published simple techniques for adjusting the automatic controllers. You can say, so there they have published, or you can say they published a research paper in which the technique is proposed in order to adjust the control parameters KP, KA, KD. Okay, and they have seen this method is, you know, widely acceptable to any of the process. Okay, so which became on this tuning is further known as the Jigler-Nicholas tuning rules, ZN tuning rules. Okay, so in 1942 this equation or this method has been proposed. Okay, so this is the research paper, you can read if you want. Okay, so just I am copying so that I can show you the, yes, okay, so this is the paper. Published by the Jigler-Nicholas. Okay. So you can see here, in this, no specialist on process control is complete without mentioning the ZN tuning rules. Okay, no series of 25 years ago, column in IEEE control system magazine, but we complete with without recognizing Nathaniel B. Nicholas, CSM, first associate editor for control system history. Nicholas is conventor of the ZN tuning rules for the PID controllers, father of the Nicholas chart. Okay, Nicholas chart is also proposed by the Nicholas, that is used for the delayed system generally. Okay, with Humbert James and Ralph Phillips of volume 25 of the MIT Radiation Laboratory series volume thermo theory of servo mechanism. In 1980, Nicholas was awarded the second ACC Control Heritage Award, now known as Richard E. Bellman Control Heritage Award, for distinguished lifetime career contribution to the technology or application of automatic control. Right. So these are some the, you know, brief of the Mr. Nicholas, Nathaniel B. Nicholas. Okay, you can read here the Nicholas, about the Nicholas. Nicholas received the BS degree from the Central Michigan University in 1936. MS from the Michigan, and the PhD, okay, on the doctor PhD from the Central Michigan University, okay, and another degree also he received honorary doctor science degree from the Western Reserve University. So these are some the you can read about the this guy, okay, and also you can read about the Ziegler, how the Nicholas met to Ziegler and proposed this techniques, okay. You can see this is the moment, okay. So now coming to the next, that is your that part. So Ziegler Nicholas published a paper in 1942, and this was the paper, okay. This was the paper by which जिसकी बात हम लोग कर रहे हैं. यू कैन ऑल्सो रीड दिस बुक ऑल्सो. ओके, यू कैन सी हियर द ऑथर नेम इज Ziegler एंड Nicholas, पब्लिश्ड इन, दिस इज नॉट दैट पेपर आई थिंक. Yes, this is a paper 1942, okay. So this is the article, okay. So you can download this paper and read, right? Okay, so these are this paper is very very important for the tuning purpose and Jordan method, right? So Ziegler Nicholas proposed this paper, published a paper in 1942 with this name. Okay. All the details of the paper is given here, and they described for the tuning of the parameters P, PI, and PID controller, proportional plus integral, and PID controller. How this tuning method is used to find the control parameters. So the two methods Ziegler Nicholas is used for the first open loop method, and then it is used for the closed loop method. Okay. So conclusion is the two process model is usually neither first order nor the linear. Okay, your system is not the linear or not the first order. Only the simplest process exhibits such ideal dynamics. Okay, we are going to convert that any process into this simpler type of the dynamics, that is the first order or LTA linear. Okay, next is the output data are usually corrupted with the noise, sure, and that is measurement contain a random component. Measurement is done with the noise measurement is done with the help of some sensor, and that also contains some random component. Okay. So noise can arise from normal operation of the process. For example, inadequate mixing that produces EDs of higher and lower concentration or temperature, or it can be result from electronic instrumentation. Okay, at the time of the measurement, the noise will come. So if noise is completely random or uncorrelated, a first order response plot may still be drawn that fits the output data well in a time average sense. However, autocorrelated random noise such as drifting disturbance can cause problem in the analysis. Means when the noise will come in the picture, the dynamics or the response of that system, when you drawing the plot of the response, you will not get the response like the first order system, right? So they will arises some problem in order to understand or analysis. So in summary, the ideal response curve, we are discussing the ideal response. Okay, we are assuming that the whatever the instrument we are using are ideal and not providing any noise, not introducing any noise. Okay. So you can see here, this is the response of the system, the first order system, and tau, this is the tau, and tau is nothing but that 63.2% of the response, where it will come 63.2% of the response, okay, right? And you can see here, this is the response by Km, okay, this is the y, okay, yt, and km is this one, okay, y upon km. How this will come, we will discuss later with our example. So, in order to account for higher order dynamics, so it means we have to neglect the higher order, or we have to convert the system into the first order model. Okay, a time delay term can be included. Time, so we have at any cost for the Ziegler-Nicholas method, we have to convert the system into the first order system. Okay, and the time for, and you may introduce, you may choose, or you can consider the time delay. Okay, you may include the time delay. The modification can improve the agreement between the model and experimental response. The fitting of the first order plus time delay model, FOPTD. This is a first order, remember. FOPTD, what is the FOPTD? So first order plus time delay system. First order plus time delay. So anyone can tell me what is the transfer function for the first order plus time delay system? Anyone? Any suggestion? First order plus time delay system. What is the transfer function for the first order system?
Minus
k upon 1 plus tau s is the first order system, and when we are introducing the time delay model, it means we have to introduce some e to the power
minus tau ds.
Tau ds, yes. So this is the transfer function for the FOPTD system. Now come to the next. You can see here e to the power minus theta s gs equals to k e to the power minus theta s upon tau. K upon tau s plus 1 is the first order system, and e to minus theta s represents the delay system. Okay. We also have seen the expression for the e to the power minus theta s using the first Peyde and second order Peyde. Yes or no? First order Peyde and the second order Peyde. Right. Now I'm coming to the next. That is the, okay. So two step input. Now I'm coming to the next. So in this method, we are going to discuss the ZN open loop method. Okay, ZN open loop method, very, very important. Then we will discuss the closed loop. So in the ZN method, ZN open loop method, the method is also known as the process reaction curve method. Why it is known as the process reaction curve method? I will show you. Process reaction curve. It is very, very important. Remember always. It is also known as the process reaction curve. Why it is called process reaction curve? You can analyze after 2-3 minutes. So what is the ZN method? What is the ZN open loop method? In this method, we obtain experimentally the open loop response. Okay, the experimental response we just observe. Okay, with the help of the step input of the first order plus time delay system. Okay, this method only applied if the response to a step input exhibit S shaped curve, H shaped curve. The response will come, the response would be in the form of the S shaped curve. Then only you are going to apply the ZN method. Okay. This means that if the plant involves integrator, second order prototype system, or complex conjugate poles, that is general second order system, then this method can be applied, since S shaped will not be obtained. So if your response will not in the form of the S shaped curve, then it is a limitation of the ZN method, ZN open loop method, you are not going to apply. Okay, so the ZN open loop method only can apply where you got the response, or you can get the response of the first order plus time delay system with a step input in the term of S shaped curve, and that S shaped curve is known as a process reaction curve. Right, and the method is known as obviously process reaction curve method or process reaction method. Okay, because you see here the response. This is the S-type curve. This is the S-type curve, right? There is a one point where the inflection is occurred. Inflection point is occurred. What is the inflection point? Inflection point is that point where the nature of the curve is changing. Convexity to concavity or concavity to convexity. You can see here the nature of the curve, is changing at this point, and then it goes like this one. Okay, so this is the inflection point. This is the inflection point, right? Or whatever the, you can see here, any inflection point, right? Now, come to the next. At the point of the inflection, this is the S curve, whatever you have observed from the response. Okay, you are in the industry and getting the response like this one of the open loop system, and the engineer or some your supervisor will say just tune the system for you, design the PID controller based on this reaction curve, based on this curve, open loop response. This is a simply open loop response, and your supervisor said just to design a PID controller based on this response. So what you will do, you just draw the tangent on the inflection point, right? Inflection point. And for the first order, you know, you are going to ultimately find the transfer function. That transfer function is nothing but the k upon 1 plus tau s e to the power minus theta s. That is the first order plus time delay system. So the first order, for the first order system, you have to calculate the value of k, you have to value tau, and you have to know the value of theta. So whenever you draw this tangent on the x-axis, okay, just to extend this tangent on the x-axis, where then it intersect to the x-axis, at that point, from the origin to this intersection point, this is known as the theta. This distance is, you can calculate as a theta, okay? And when you extend this tangent in the above portion, you can see here in this diagram, and when you just extend a line from the y-axis parallel to the x-axis, okay, so where it will meet, the response will meet, okay, that value, from this value you can say this is the value of tau. This value is tau. Is it clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
So is time, t is equals to nothing but the theta plus tau. Okay, total time is theta plus tau. You can compute the value of theta, you can compute the value of tau. Now also, you know the response of the system, so y is equals to, you can also calculate the value of km. Y is equals to km, right? Okay, so we will discuss from one example, then you can understand it. Okay, so now come to the next part, that is the Ziegler-Nicholas open loop tuning method. Perform the following steps. What we have to do, you have to calculate the process value k is found by calculating the ratio of steady state change in y to size of input change m. What is m? Yes, nobody have asked. What is m? What is this m? M is the step input. Okay, m amount of step has been given, right? And what is the k? K is the gain. Okay, so we are going to find the system gain. So k is equal to nothing but the y upon m. M is the step change, y is the response, steady state value, you can say. Okay, so you can find the value of k like this one. Also, a tangent is drawn at the point of inflection of the step response. The intersection of the tangent line and the time axis is the time delay, that is the theta. If the tangent is extended to the intersect of the steady state response, you can see here this value, we are going to extend this value. Okay, intersect the steady state response line, y is equals to km. the point of intersection correspond to the t is equals to theta plus tau. T is equals to the total time is equals to theta plus tau. So you can calculate the value of tau by minus of theta. Tau can be found by subtracting the theta from the point of intersection. Okay. Now the last point is, once you get the value of tau, value of k, value of theta, then only point is you have to calculate now kc, tau i and tau d for the tuning purpose, for the PID controller value. You have to calculate this value only. You are interested in find the value, this value. Okay? Because your supervisor has asked to design a control, design a PID controller. Okay? So, in order to that, the table, the Ziegler-Nicholas proposed a table, generalized table. Generalized table. And generalized table, बस मैं class को बात करता हूँ. तो for the proportional controller, for the proportional controller, the kc can be found by k, tau is equals to tau by k theta, tau by k theta. Okay. For the PI controller, he given 0.9 tau divided by k theta. Okay, and for the PI, the proportional plus integral is also given. So the integral, the t I tau y is can be found by the theta divided by 0.3. जरा एक मिनट ऑफिस आना.
हेलो.
एक मिनट ऑफिस आ जा. And the value of PID, that is the KC tau and tau d unit. So you can determine with the help of this table, okay? So generally this table will provide it to you, okay? Or if not provided, then you have to remember this table, okay? In order to find out the value of Kp, tau and tau d. Or in somewhere, if it is given, if it is asked to find the Ki or Kd, so you can determine with the help of the relation between the Ki and tau i. Okay, now I'm coming to the next part, that is the disadvantage. So I already told you what the disadvantage. First disadvantage is where the S set, it is only limited to the first order plus time in the system. And if the S set response will not come, then such type of you can't able to apply the ZN open loop method. Okay, and open loop response you need in order to find determine. Okay, and also the time delay estimation. Okay, if you are the inflection point, if you are not able to find out the inflection point, okay, the point of inflection, to search the point of inflection is not a very easy task. Okay, so for that purpose, the computation of this point is not very easy. And if it's not easy, it means you are not able to find out the value of time delay, that is theta. Okay, theta, because all depends on the point of inflection. And if your point of inflection is wrong, if you are wrongly chosen, then it means you are not able to find the correct value of the theta. Okay, so Sundarshan and Krishna Swami in 1978 proposes, he just modify, okay, or you can say he just avoided the usage of the point of inflection construction, okay, entirely to estimate the time delay. Just he avoided in to find the point of inflection. Okay, so how they have found? So they have proposed, you know, two times t1 and t2. Wo do bar t1 calculate kar lo, but t2 calculate kar lo. Be estimated from a step response curve. And this time t1 t2, what is this t1 time t1 t2? T1 t1 correspond to the 35%. And 35% aapka jahan par aa raha hai us value ko, aur 85.3% aa raha hai us value ko. So that's t1 and t2, just you record it. Okay, and then apply this value. Just put this value in this equation. The theta is equal to, you can determine, the tau you can determine. Again, if you know the theta and tau, then you know you can just put the input in the table and you can find the value. Okay, so I hope it is you understand it. Okay, so wait for a minute. यहाँ पे सर एक साइन होने यहाँ पे चलिए हाँ और एक साइन होने हैं यहाँ दो और एक साइन होने हैं यहाँ पे मुझे ओके सो यू अंडरस्टैंड इट हाउ इट इज कैलकुलेटेड टाउ थीटा एंड टाउ राइट You can see here the tau 1 and tau 2, how this tau 1 and tau 2 can be calculated, okay? So the main, what is the disadvantage of this tuning the main disadvantage of the open loop tuning method is that it is performed with the controller switch to manual, okay? When you are going to, actually in the industry, you know, you are, once the controller is, controller you can say, controller connected, okay. So first you have to controller switched in the mode manual mode, then only you are going to record the open loop response, okay. So at that time the controller is not working, the leaving the output uncontrolled in open loop. So this may be you can say hazardous for the system, okay, because you are not able to control the response or open loop response, okay. So this is the main disadvantage. So Ziegler-Nicholas continuous cycling method described. Next is a well-known closed loop tuning method. So the next closed loop tuning method he has proposed, okay, where the control is connected in the switching mode, not in the manual mode, right? So such type of problem can may be avoided with the in the closed loop method, okay? So this is the next part we will discuss. So I'm just leaving here.